Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I am Priyanka Bansode and today we are going to study about analogous system. In that, we are going to see about force voltage analogy. These are the learning outcomes of this video lecture. At the end of this session, students will be able to define analogy and state the types of analogous system, and also students will be able to explain force voltage analogy. These are the contents of this video lecture. First, we see about analogous system. We are having two different physical systems with the same mathematical model. Then they will be called as analogous system. In between electrical and mechanical systems, there exists a fixed analogy and exists a similarity between the equilibrium equations. Due to this, it is possible to draw an electrical system which will behave exactly similar to the given mechanical system. This is called electrical analogous of given mechanical system, and vice versa. There are two methods of obtaining electrical analogous networks. First, force voltage analogy, that is direct analogy. And second is force current analogy, that is inverse analogy. Consider simple mechanical system as shown in figure 1. The mechanical translation system having three elements as spring, mass and friction. M is the mass, B is the friction or damper, and spring constant is denoted as K. Due to applied force, mass M will displace by an amount X in the direction of force F as shown in figure. Now, before moving towards, pause this video for few seconds and you have to think and write the mathematical equation for the mechanical system. So, according to Newton's law of motion, sum of forces applied on rigid body or system must be equal to sum of forces consumed to produce displacement, velocity and acceleration in various elements of system. So, the mathematical equation becomes F of T is equal to M into A plus B into V plus K into X of T, where A is the acceleration and V is the velocity and X of T is the displacement. So, equation becomes F of t is equal to m d square x of t by dt square plus b d x of t by dt plus k x of t. Then taking Laplace of above equation, and the equation becomes F of s is equal to m s square x of s plus b s x of s plus k into x of s. So, this is the equilibrium equation for the given translation mechanical system. Already, we know that the mechanical system has two types. One is the translational and the other is rotational system. So, we will see force voltage analogy for translational as well as for rotational system. Now, we are moving towards the main point of this video lecture, that is force voltage analogy for translation mechanical system. Now we will try to derive analogous electrical network. Consider an electrical network as shown in figure. In this method, to the force in mechanical system, voltage is assumed to be analogous one, means force F is analogous to voltage V. Accordingly, we will try to derive other analogous terms. Consider an electrical network. Here, R, L and C are connected in series? According to Kirchhoff's law, the equation can be written as V of t is equal to R I of t plus L d I of t by dt plus 1 by C integration of I of t dt. Now, taking Laplace of both sides, the equation becomes V of s is equal to R I of s plus L s I of s plus 1 by S C I of s. This is the equation of V of s. Now, we compare F of s and V of s. But here, we cannot compare F of s and V of s directly because they are not in the same form. So, for that, we will use current as the rate of flow of charge. So, I of t is equal to dq by dt. Now, taking Laplace, then the equation becomes I of s is equal to sq of s. I of s is equal to sq of s, or q of s is equal to I of s by s. Replacing this term in above equation, so final equation of V of s becomes V of s is equal to L s square q of s plus R s q of s plus 1 by C q of s. Now, F of s and V of s are in the same form. Now, comparing equations for F of s and V of s. From above equations, we can say that inductance L is analogous to mass M. Then, resistance R is analogous to friction constant B. And reciprocal of capacitor, that is 1 by C, is analogous to spring constant K. Now, we have compared translational, mechanical and electrical systems. Here, we compare the analogous elements in translation motion. So, first, force is analogous to voltage V. Then, mass M is analogous to inductance L. Then, friction constant B is analogous to resistance R. Then, spring constant K is analogous to reciprocal of capacitor. Then, displacement X is analogous to charge Q. And the last is velocity V, that is dx by dt, is analogous to the current I, that is dq by dt. Now, let us see mechanical rotational system. In this figure, this is the motion about fixed axis. In such systems, the force gets replaced by a moment about the fixed axis, that is called as torque. Then, from the figure, torque is represented by T, inertia is represented by J, omega is angular velocity, then theta of T is the angular displacement, and alpha is angular acceleration. So, according to Newton's law of motion, the equation of rotational system is T of t is equal to J alpha plus K theta of t plus B omega. Here, alpha is equal to d omega by dt and omega is equal to d theta by dt. So, put the values of alpha and omega in the above equation. So, the equation becomes T of t is equal to J d square theta of t by dt square plus b d theta by dt plus k theta of t. Taking Laplace of both sides, so the equation becomes T of s is equal to j s square theta of s plus b s theta of s plus k theta of s. Now, this is the equilibrium equation of rotational system. Now let us see force voltage analogy for rotational mechanical system. Now again compare the equations of T of S and V of S. From above equations, it is clear that inductance L is analogous to inertia J. Then resistance R is analogous to torsional friction constant B. Then reciprocal of capacitor is analogous to spring constant K. Now, finally, we compare the analogous elements of rotational system with electrical system. So first, torque T is analogous to voltage V. Then inertia J is analogous to inductance L. Then torsional friction constant B is analogous to resistance R. Torsional spring constant K is analogous to reciprocal of capacitor. Then angular displacement, that is theta, is analogous to charge Q. And the last one, angular velocity alpha is analogous to the current I. So in this video lecture, we have discussed force voltage analogy for translational as well as for rotational system. These are the references of this video lecture. Thank you.